at 8, the city of Sanger reported its first homicide since 2022 earlier today.
I'm Steven Gomez, MyTV 53 News at 8.
Flying out of Fresno International Airport this Thanksgiving, I'm Emma Ott, and we have everything you need to know before you go with MyTV 53 News at 8.
Also tonight...
Yeah, so about 2:30 this afternoon, started receiving calls for a commercial fire near California Dairies.
Plus, do you really need to head to an emergency room if you are sick during the holidays? Michael Wells will tell you why the county of Fresno is changing the rules. We are also following breaking news in the war between Israel and Hamas. A deal for hostages being released has just been made. Your news in primetime is next.
New, local, unique. MyTV 53 News at 8 starts right now.
Hi, everybody. Good evening. This is the San Joaquin Valley's only 8 p.m. news, and I'm Austin Reed. It's Tuesday, November the 21st. Thanks for welcoming us into your life. Hey, our big story tonight is in Sanger, where the city recorded its first homicide since 2022. The shooting happened here at about 10:15 this morning. Sanger PD received multiple calls reporting shots fired in the 800 block of Sequoia Avenue. New at 8, reporter Stephen Gomez is in Sanger with the very latest.
Officers responded to the scene and located a man suffering from gunshot wounds. Officers initiated immediate life-saving efforts and then Sanger EMS took over, transporting him to CRMC where he later died from his injuries. The motive of the crime is currently under investigation. Sanger PD recovered a vehicle believed to be involved near Rainbow Road and California Avenue, just north of the city of Sanger. The investigation is being led by Sanger PD investigators with assistance from the Fresno County Sheriff's Office.
No word yet on a suspect or suspects. This incident marks the first homicide in Sanger since February 2022. Reporting in Sanger tonight, I'm Steven Gomez, MyTV 53 News at 8.
All right, Steven, thank you for that. Other news and new tonight from the Tulare County Sheriff's Office. A shooting into a field of farm workers sends one person to the hospital. Just after 12:15 this afternoon, deputies were called to the shooting in a vineyard near Avenue 152 and Road 200. That's just west of Porterville, where field workers were harvesting grapes. When they arrived, deputies learned that a man in a gray Honda drove up and began firing toward an empty canal about 100 yards away from the field workers. One of the workers, a 45-year-old woman, was shot in the hand and sustained minor injuries. She was taken to an area hospital for treatment. Tonight, the suspect is described as a man in his mid-20s driving a gray Honda. Well, this just in from the Fresno Fire Department. California Dairies in downtown Fresno was evacuated after a blaze broke out in one of the buildings earlier this afternoon.
When the units went en route, there was a large column of smoke coming from the building. Upon arrival, they've kind of identified that the fire that is suspected to be in one of the drying units. This is a dairy. It's part of their commercial operations here. The sprinkler system was activated, and we're supporting the sprinkler system with the use of our fire engines supplying water.
The fire started right around 2:30 this afternoon at F Street and Ventura Avenues. Everyone inside the plant made it out okay. Crews spent most of the afternoon and early evening to fully extinguish the flames. Firefighters were on the scene of a blaze in a two-story townhome near California and Fowler Avenues that broke out shortly after 6 this morning. 22 Fresno firefighters responded to this incident. The cause of the blaze is still under investigation. A total of 8 people, though, were displaced, with one person being evaluated for smoke inhalation. We have one more structure fire to tell you about. This one broke out earlier this morning in Visalia. This happened on Ben Maddox and St. John's River in the city of Visalia. Tulare County Fire was first on scene and even called in assistance from the Visalia Fire Department. No injuries were reported here. The cause of the fire still under investigation. 2 southbound lanes of traffic were blocked by fire units during today's morning rush hour. Staying in the South Valley late yesterday, Tulare County prosecutors filed criminal charges against Visalia man Fidel Jose Madrigal, 33 years old, after an investigation by Visalia PD relating to crimes against children. Madrigal is charged with one count of possession of child porn, with the special allegations that he possesses prior felony convictions. The man is currently a registered sex offender after a 2015 conviction for showing or distributing porn to a minor, as well as misdemeanor annoying or molesting a child. The man pleaded not guilty at an arraignment yesterday and is currently in custody on a $100,000 bail. The bail hearing is now scheduled for November the 28th. We learned tonight that late last week in Department 10 of the Tulare County Superior Court, the court sentenced 42-year-old Octavio Larias to life in prison for child molestation. The man will also be required to register as a sex offender for the remainder of his life. On October 23rd of this year, the man pleaded no contest to one count of sexual intercourse with a child 10 years old or younger and one count of forcible lewd acts upon a child under the age of 14. All crimes involved substantial sexual conduct. Each count is a felony and considered strike offenses. The crimes occurred between 2016 and 2020 against a female victim who was between 10 and 14 years old at the time of the assaults. The crime occurred in the city of Tulare. Well, switching gears now, today and tomorrow mark the busiest time of the year for holiday travelers during the Thanksgiving holiday. New tonight, MyTV53's Emma Ott spoke with representatives from the Fresno Yosemite International Airport who are offering tips for people flying. Emma?
Hi, Austin. It is safe to say that air travel this week is going to be hectic. Airports nationwide, including Fresno Yosemite International Airport, will be very busy during the Thanksgiving travel period, which begins Friday, November 17th, and concludes on Tuesday, November 28th.
Travelers flying through Fresno Yosemite International Airport this holiday season can expect the airport to be busy. And this is why we recommend and encourage travelers to arrive early for their flights.
AAA is forecasting that 4.7 million people will be flying for Thanksgiving. That's a 6% jump compared to 2022. Public Information Officer for the Fresno Yosemite International Airport gives us an inside look at what we can expect.
We are prepared. We have, additional, staff that are looking out for, things that, travelers might be in need of. Our teams are always available to help support with airlines that may need some support at their airline ticket counters, and not necessarily customer service support, but if they are in need of some assistance with helping to facilitate maybe lines that are forming at airline ticket counters, directing foot traffic, directing vehicles out front, curbside. So we do have staff available to help with those support areas.
The Transportation Security Administration, or TSA, projects the busiest day during the 12-hour travel period are Tuesday and Wednesday prior to Thanksgiving and the Sunday afterward. Passengers are encouraged to arrive early and be prepared for travel, with flights anticipated to be at or near capacity. Fewer options may be available to accommodate rebooking if flights are missed.
Flights at Fresno Yosemite are expected to be full or at capacity or near capacity, so we are anticipating it to be very busy at the airport. And again, that's why we encourage passengers to arrive early for their flights.
While many will be traveling in the skies, AAA estimates 88% of Americans, nearly 49 million people, will be hitting the roads this year. The busiest day for drivers are the Wednesday before Thanksgiving and the weekend after. According to AAA, they are expecting to see an 11% jump in traffic on Wednesday from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. It's recommended to get on the road before 11 o'clock in the morning if you want to beat traffic. I'm Emma Ott, wishing everyone safe travels this weekend with MyTV53 News at 8. Happy Thanksgiving.
All right, Emma, thank you for that. Also new from the Fresno Air Terminal. Sounding good. The seventh season of the holiday music at the airport is now in full swing. The music program officially kicked off this morning at 11. So if you're going to be traveling through FAT, stop by the end of the terminal and enjoy the sounds of the season. Brought to you this year by Andrea, Adeline, Eliza, Ike, and Carrie. And finally, in your first few minutes of nonstop news at 8, with infections on the rise, the County of Fresno is working to ensure people who really need to be seen at the emergency room get the care they need. And the ones who aren't sick enough get care in a different way. New at 8, reporter Michael Wells from our partners at Stuwell News explains.
Fresno County wants to make sure that people who say they need to go to the hospital have a really good reason for it. On Friday, the county's Department of Public Health announced it's bringing back its controversial assess and refer policy. The goal is to keep people who don't truly have an emergency out of hospital emergency departments, which in turn would help slow the spread of COVID-19, the flu, and other viruses. The policy lets ambulance crews assess a patient out in the field and lets them determine if they should transport that person in the ambulance to the hospital. The county is also encouraging you to get a flu shot and a COVID-19 shot. It's been holding clinics where you can get them for free. Michael Wells, Stuwell News for MyTV 53 News at 8.
Michael, thank you for that. That does it for your first few minutes of nonstop news today. But don't go anywhere. We are just getting started. Still ahead.
On Sunday afternoon, Aaron Judge and former head coach Mike Batesole got their numbers retired together.
Also ahead, we're following breaking news in the war between Israel and Hamas. A deal for hostages has just been announced. We'll explain. But next, the Holiday Cottage is now open in Kern County. Allie Soper will have those details. And we are getting closer to Thanksgiving. How's it looking weather-wise? We've got your updated forecast as well. New, local, unique. This is MyTV 53 News at 8. Don't go anywhere. We're back in a little over 2 minutes.
Is MyTV 53 News. New, local, unique with Austin Reed. You're watching MyTV 53 News at 8.
Hey, welcome back on this 21st of November. New tonight from the city of Fresno, they have unveiled a new tool to combat graffiti in the city. Today, members from the Public Works Department announced the new bucket truck will now allow the city's graffiti team to achieve new heights in their battles to keep Fresno graffiti free. The new $192,000 truck will include a specially trained crew that will reach graffiti in hard to access areas. The crews were trained on protection from falls and use of the vehicle. There are 16 total graffiti positions within the city. Right now, 12 of those positions are filled with 4 new team members joining the city by the end of the year. Fresno's graffiti team responds to calls 7 days a week, and most calls are answered within 24 hours of reporting. It takes the team an average of 20 minutes to remove a single piece of graffiti. To help this city fight this, just report it to 311 or use the FresGo app. Turning to our big stories in Kern County now for our viewers watching on KNXT 53. Back in May, the Greenfield Walking Group decided to adopt Stern Park as part of the City of Bakersfield's Rec and Parks Department's Adopt a Park program. Well, yesterday morning, after 6 months, they received their sign as official adopters of Stern Park. During the ceremony on Monday, the city thanked them for their hard work, helping to keep the park clean and showing pride in their community. Well, in the county of Kern, Holiday Cottage is now open. New tonight, reporter Allie Soper from kerncounty.com sheds more light.
you can now donate to the Department of Human Services 36th Annual Holiday Cottage. Community members are invited to fulfill Christmas wishes for local children in foster care by helping purchase their holiday gifts. Right now, you can sign up to make a child's Christmas wish come true by monetarily donating or directly purchasing their gift to make their holiday season a little brighter.
So the Holiday Cottage is a program that the Department of Human Services started in 1987. So we've been doing it a long time, and we want to make sure children in foster care know that we care about them and that they're not forgotten during the holidays, which can be a lonely time for them, not with their biological families, but it's a way for the community to connect and for them to know that somebody who doesn't even know them cares about them.
To get involved, please visit kcdhs.org. The holidays are right around the corner, and Kern County's workforce is coming together to help feed local families in need. Anna Marie Odo has the story.
The Board of Supervisors proclaimed November and December as Kern County Cares Canned Food Drive Month. County staff are encouraged to collect non-perishable food items, as well as monetary donations for the Golden Empire Gleaners to distribute canned food items to our community's most vulnerable. Last year, Kern County collected more than 132,000 pounds of food. This year, the goal is to reach 150,000 pounds of collected food. If you'd like to contribute or participate in a special charity golf tournament at the Kern River Golf Course, please contact the Kern County Department of Human Services or visit their website, kcdhs.org.
And that does it for us on this week's Around Kern County. If you have a story you'd like to share, please visit kerncounty.com and fill out our Submit a Story form. We hope you have a very happy Thanksgiving.
My TV 53 News continues with the Valley's local forecast.
We are back now with breaking news and new information in the war between Israel and Hamas. Just about an hour and a half ago, a deal to release hostages seized by Hamas in Israel in exchange for a pause in fighting in Gaza was announced. This is according to CNN. The full Israeli cabinet convened to discuss the deal. They were meeting all day about this. The deal releases 50 women and children and leads to a 4 to 5 day pause in fighting. According to sources, 3 Palestinian prisoners will be freed for every civilian hostage that is released. Meanwhile, almost 1.7 million people have been displaced in Gaza since October 7th, a UN agency said. In more local news tonight and in the North Valley, the city of Merced is welcoming a seasoned legal expert as the new city of Merced attorney. The city announced the appointment of Craig J. Conwell. He's a legal professional with over 23 years of experience in providing advice to council bodies and city management. The city says the man is a well-rounded attorney with expertise in various areas. The city of Merced also says they conducted an extensive search to find a candidate. Time now for sports shorts. Aaron Judge returned back to Fresno State this past weekend for his jersey retirement ceremony. New at 8, reporter Valentina Saldana is in the newsroom with more.
On Sunday afternoon, Aaron Judge and former head coach Mike Batesole got their numbers retired together. Here's what Judge had to say about the momentous occasion.
nobody else I'd rather share this moment with. You know, it's the lessons I learned from Coach. You know, some of them tough lessons, some of them good lessons. It's just, you know, all of it at the time, you know, I may have been angry, I may have been upset about, you know, why is he getting on me so much? But then when you look back at it, and once you're out of here and you see how he set me up for my life, not only as, you know, in my baseball career, but as a young man, as a family man.
Before the ceremony began, Judge signed merchandise and took pictures as lots of young fans gathered around and on top the left field dugout. Once the ceremony started, Batesol and Judge both shared their gratitude towards people that have led them to this moment, such as parents, friends, and family. They also shared a couple of stories from when they were both at Fresno State. Batesol's number 44 went on the outfield, while Judge's number 29 went on the press box. Batesol spent 20 seasons coaching the Diamond Dogs from 2003 to 2022. During that time, he led Fresno State to a national championship in 2008, multiple conference championships, and lots of athlete nominations to conference teams. As for Judge, he spent 3 seasons as a Diamond Dog from 2011 to 2013. He won the College Baseball Home Run Derby, earned conference recognition, and was drafted by the Yankees in the 3rd round. Now, they have officially and permanently left their mark at Fresno State.
That is all for Sports Shorts. I'm Valentina Salaña. Austin, back to you.
All right, Valentina, thank you much. We have another We Work For You series from the city of Fresno. That's next in prime time. Hey, welcome back. Finally tonight, the Regional Sports Complex is 110 acres. It's a park in Southwest Fresno. And over the last year, public works crews have worked hard to bring the landscaping to life. And now it is up to Jesus Martinez and his teammates to keep it that way. Here's the latest We Work For You series from the city.
Hi, my name is Jesus Martinez and my job title is irrigation specialist. This is a sports complex, regional sports complex. My goal out here is to keep the park green. In order to do that, we have to have the water flowing, making sure everything's running, pump, rotors, they're all working, not plugged or broken, replace those, replace a valve if it's not working, or just if it have a break or a leak, replace it. This park was completely dead everywhere. Out here, dirt, the back, dirt.
What changed?
Teamwork. We all came in, do valve replace, do rotors, everything. Gate valves, did a lot of work, pop-ups, and basically the whole team from our team, our department and street department, they came in and everyone helped.
Super important work there. Let's get a final look at your forecast from Fresno to Bakersfield. Of course, a lot of people are hitting the roads or they're flying. Locally, we're looking good. Temperatures, it was a little bit warmer today, right? That'll continue tomorrow. But then Thanksgiving, temperatures will be in the 60s, partly to mostly sunny skies. All right, we'll be back tomorrow. Thanks for watching tonight. I'm Austin Breed. Hoping your news is good news. Take care.